Hello everyone and welcome back to the Seasonal Storm. I have yet another back to school haul. This is all I seem to do apparently these days, which that's okay. We're going to be moving on from back to school very, very soon. So I thank you all for your patience. And for those of you who've tuned in and this has helped, maybe this one will help you too. I guess we'll find out and see. So if you're interested in that, stay tuned. And then we're also going to be DIYing something. So I'll see you in a second.
I'd like to go ahead and give credit to the two accounts that inspired this video, one being Pretty and Flawed. She does not only fantastic Dollar Tree hauls and Shop With Me's as well, but has great lifestyle content, and the other being the family channel Crazy Middles.
Okay, so I thought I had everything for kids back to school. We haven't even touched substitute teacher back to school yet. I'm not ready to do that mentally. Yes, I am. I have to be. I have to be ready for next week. But we're not there yet. But where we are today is I realized while watching another YouTuber assembling hers, I went, oh my gosh, I forgot the emergency kit. And a lot of you are going, what the heck is an emergency kit and why does your child need one? First of all, I actually did not come up with this idea, which is not surprising. Lots of people have this idea. Secondly, actually, I will credit her mom. Her mom put one of these in her backpack probably 2 years ago now. And I remember at the time being like, oh my gosh, what is going on in elementary school? They need an emergency kit. And then it dawned on me, I was the slightly awkward kid once upon a time who didn't want to ask for a Band-Aid, who didn't want to ask for chapstick, who didn't want to ask for a towelette for my hands. And I was like, duh, this makes perfect sense. So we're doing that mini haul today and then a few more last minute back to school items. So we're going to get into it. We went to Dollar Tree, went to Kroger. First step, we're going to start at Kroger. And I got two items there. Neither of these are exciting. I wanted to get hand wipes. But for PE this year, I remember as a kid, hand wipes don't always do the job. So I went ahead and I picked up just some basic women's wipes from Summer's Eve, just the little travel individual package ones. So that was a buck, great. And then from the travel section, I also got a little mini Degree dry protection deodorant. So it's the dry chalky one, not the gel one, because kids do not like gel. And so we snagged one of those too. She doesn't really use either of these items all that often, but again, I know that when you're in a new environment and you're doing PE for the first time after 2 years of not having PE because of the global situation we've been in, you don't want to be in an environment where you feel hot and sticky and sweaty or embarrassed or anything like that. And you don't want to have to make yourself feel uncomfortable by talking to a teacher about it. So knowing that you have the tools to take care of, you know, your little sweat issue or whatever is, if she never uses it, perfect. But in the event that she needs it, it is there. So for $2 at Kroger, we got ourselves started. And then I went to Dollar Tree. And as always at Dollar Tree, I somehow ended up on the craft aisle. So that haul should have already gone up by now. But we went there for these specific items. And then on my way to the craft aisle, I passed the back to school aisle and I found the little snack containers that I love with the pop sides in a pack of three. And normally they're only in a pack of two. So I grabbed one of these for $1. So three for a buck. Excellent deal. These wash wonderfully in the dishwasher. I don't have one, but I know they wash wonderfully in the dishwasher. So if you have one, that's a good buy. So then I finally made it where I needed to go. And the first thing I grabbed was a very nondescript little tiny pouch. It has a regular zipper and has plenty of room for me to put a name on it. It's not anything crazy. Put it in a pocket that's not going to be mistaken for school supplies. There we go. So for a buck, we grabbed our pouch. So for emergency kit, we're up to $3. And then I also know that sometimes your hair can get tangly after PE. So I grabbed her a little hairbrush. Now, obviously, this is not the quality of the hairbrushes we have at home. We all know that. Nobody is buying the hairbrush at the Dollar Tree expecting, you know, salon quality. But in a pinch, they will work. And this one I liked because it also had a little mirror. And because she has braces, in the event that she ever has something stuck in her braces and needs to get it out or doesn't have access to a mirror or doesn't want to go all the way to the bathroom, this is an option for her. So with a little mirror, just, I remember getting these in like little gift favors and like people's birthdays. Was that a weird thing in the early 2000s? I don't know, but we always got these in gift bags at birthdays. So anyway, they fold up like this. So we're up to $4 for our emergency kit. Next up for school this year, it sounds like they might be under mask mandates again. So I bought a 2-pack of the Orly Fashion Cotton Face Masks, machine washable. And she has tons of masks, but you know, it's always good to have some new ones. So maybe we'll put, she doesn't really like super cutesy things. And these are reversible, so they're, you know, obviously white on the inside and a color on the outside. So one was black and one was pink, because she doesn't really love pink. If she needs a backup mask, I'll just put this one in her emergency kit, and then this one will go with her school supplies. So for her emergency kit, we're up to a whopping $4.50. And then I grabbed her some hair ties. I love these ones because they don't tangle and they're just like the rolled fabric kind. And her favorite colors are blue and black. And this kind of goes with, well, not that actually doesn't go with her hair at all, but okay. Anyway, we got her the blue and black. So we'll throw hair ties in the emergency kit. I'm gonna go grab a chapstick from my stash in the bathroom and then we will pack this thing. Okay, so some of the first items that I'm tucking into her little bag include a flosser for her braces in case she loses the ones that are in her lunch, some spare socks in case her socks get wet and like a puddle or something at school, because I remember as a kid that was always the worst. And then I also grabbed a little nail file, so I'm gonna tuck that in. I know some people send their kids to school with nail clippers. Our district doesn't allow that, so we're not gonna do that. We're gonna tuck in our little deodorant, and as I said, if she never has to use it, whatever. We're gonna tuck in our wet wipes as well, and as you can see, they come in individual nondescript packaging, so we'll go ahead and sneak those in. I mean, no one's gonna be able to notice this in her bag anyway if I do this effectively. So we got that going in. And then I grabbed the little hairbrush and then a little chapstick ball. So we've got our hairbrush in, we've got our chapstick. Even though she should not need them this year, because if you're coughing, you shouldn't be at school anyway, grab some cough drops. And then we're going to roll up our backup mask, tuck it into our little emergency kit. And there we go. Already just get tucked into a backpack and left completely alone. I think that this is a great idea for kids of any age, any gender, because you never know when you're gonna need some Band-Aids, a flosser for your braces, maybe that extra clothing item that yours got dirty, wet, messy, whatever the issue is. Some deodorant because you're self-conscious about your body odor, some wet wipes because your hands got sticky during a class craft. Whatever the situation is, having just a little tiny stash or supply of those necessary items, and whether it's a pencil case, the backpack, your lunchbox, whatever it is, takes that one little level of anxiety away from the child and just gives them more ability to enjoy their school day and not worry about stuff that shouldn't be important. So if this is one thing I can do that reduces some anxiety and lets us have an easy breezy school year, perfect. If she never uses this, perfect. Either way, it is there in the event that she needs it. And so for that, I will let y'all get to it. And I will see you guys in the next one. We have even more back to school content coming. I have fall DIYs coming. We have wedding DIYs coming. We have more shop with me's coming. We've got it all coming. So we will see you in the next one. Thanks for stopping by today. Bye-bye now.
If you're interested in more back to school content, check out the playlist below where we share money saving hacks and DIY tips and tricks.